In 1976, when Ronald Reagan pursued the Republican presidential nomination, he repeatedly told the story of an African-American woman named Linda Taylor, claiming she was earning more than $150,000 a year by cheating social services, holding her up as an example of liberal policies gone wrong.
Well, compared to some of you white people, I think I've done pretty damn good to be black.
The story grabbed attention, but had little basis in reality. Taylor was a con artist and not at all representative of the typical welfare recipient.
The welfare queen image is a manufacture of Ronald Reagan and the Republican Party using only one story from Chicago in the 1970s of one woman who scammed something from the system, and it's not entirely clear all that she scammed.
There's this notion that 99% of the welfare money in this society is going to black and Hispanics. It's wrong, it's bogus, because the majority of people on welfare are white. The majority of people on food stamps are white.
Ain't no love in the heart of the city. Ain't no love in the heart of town.
Reagan's attack on welfare marked a significant change. Since the Great Depression, the federal government had offered aid to poor people, the majority of whom were white. Now, in financially insecure times, Reagan hinted that those programs, paid for by tax dollars, were only aiding black people. And he promised that cutting them would help fix the economy.
This is a turning point, not only in the history of black people, but it's a turning point in the ways in which people can talk about poverty. Because we've moved from this idea of the deserving poor to the undeserving poor. And it's very much a kind of emphasis upon morality and moralism and all these kinds of things that are much more invested in the idea of individual failure than asking, how did we wind up with this population of impoverished people in the first place?